really, when you're designing to buy a new shoe, there's a lot of different things to consider. I mean, the industry itself is ginormous. There's a million and one choices. You know, where do you even start? There's new technology coming out every year, addressing speed, injury prevention, comfort, weight, and I know there's all these different new tricks and trends out there happening. But we really want to say, forget all that stuff, and we want the shoe to be something that is personal to you. So really want to keep things consistent. We find that changing your shoe all the time is actually has negative effects, because it means that your body is constantly trying to keep up with all the adaptations that you're making to it. So really the take-home message is don't change your shoe or your footwear for running unless you absolutely really need to. Kind of that old saying, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, when it comes to shoes. Really, we should be focusing on two things. The comfort, so obviously if it's not comfortable, don't even bother. And that's what it makes it difficult, you know, shopping online and trying to buy shoes that you've never tried on. It makes that a really tricky, slippery slope. And two, weight. So again, the weight changes a lot of different factors and parts of the shoe. So again, the weight plays a huge role in how that shoe functions. However, though, if you are trying to improve your run, so basically you're trying to shave time off, you're managing injury, it may be time to look at a new pair of shoes. So really, when we're thinking about a new pair of shoes, you're either going to go to a thinner sole or a thicker sole. And what we like to consider is when you are changing, especially if you're going to go to a thinner soled shoe, that you make that transition slowly. So you're not basically going to just toss your old pair of shoes out and then just start running with that new pair. Rather, you're going to kind of slowly integrate that new shoe into your routine. So for example, if you're running 4 days a week, you're going to run 2 days with your new shoe and 2 days with your old shoe.